So first we have the second one, which is the square of binomials in our spatial products. So here we have a plus b, and the other one is a minus b. We have a plus b times a plus b. We have a plus b and a plus b. They are the same. And when we get that one, 2, that is the exponent of this one and the exponent of this one. We know in multiplication, we add exponent, 1 plus 1 equals 2. And then copy the base. The other one there is a minus b times a minus b. So the base is a minus b, and then 1 plus 1 is to the second power. So here plus, we have, how did we get this one? The shortcut. We are doing the shortcut now. Not the Buff method or the distributive property, but we are going to have a shortcut for this. Actually, that's what's the process. We square this, just like the standard difference. A times a is squared. We square this, we have plus. Y plus, even if this one is negative, because we are going to square it, it is negative times negative, it's still positive. So this is always positive. We square this. B times B is B squared. Okay, what about this one? So for this one, okay, this one's positive, that's positive, you know, it's positive. Or if this one's positive, just put positive there. And then you multiply this A times B. So you have A times B. The first term times the second term. Times 2, because there will be 2. So you multiply it by 2. Don't forget the 2. Okay? The 2 will always be there. So don't forget the 2. So when we arrange it, A squared is there. The B squared, which is always plus, is there. And then the middle term here is 2ab. Okay? We square the a is squared. We square the b because negative times negative is positive. We have also b is squared. Square the a, square the b. And then positive here times negative here, it's negative. Then we multiply. But we know already that we need to have the 2 times 2. So we have 2 here times this one, the first term, times the second term. And if we are trying to arrange that one, we have this one. So we have only plus and minus. So we have here, square this one. 2x times 2x. Okay, 2 first. 2 times 2, 4. X times x. X, 1, 1, 2. Right, last one. Negative times negative, positive. 5 times 5, 25. Right. Positive times negative, okay, it's negative. Don't forget the 2 times. And then put the 2x here. And put the 5 here. So, 4x squared. Now I'm going to put this one, the last one, and put this one in the middle. Okay, negative, negative, 2 times 2, 4 times 5 is 20. Oh, there's still x there. X. And then you put the plus 25 here. And you have your answer. Let's follow each other. X squared times x squared, 2 plus 2 is x to the 4th. This one is for the x squared. Plus, so we have the plus. We have the 2, don't forget the 2. And then times d this one here, copy, x squared times the a squared there, times a squared. And thus is always plus. And what is the square of this one? A squared times a squared is a to the fourth. Right? This x to the fourth here plus. And then plus here, it's plus here. 2 times x squared times a squared, there's no number, only 2. So you put the 2 here, because a, if you want to follow alphabetically, you have to write the a squared here, and the x squared. That's the middle term. And then plus the a to the fourth. That's number 2. Roughly, we have 3x squared squared. So you have 3 times 3 is 9. X squared times x squared is x to the fourth. Positive times negative, or you know it's negative, that's the formula. It's minus here. Don't forget the 2. Put the 3x squared here, copy. What square is 3x squared, bracket, it's times, and parenthesis, and then 2. And then thus is plus always, because negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Then we got this 9x to the 4th. Now this one is minus, you put the minus here. Numbers 2 times 3, 6 times 2 is 12 letters x squared. And then last is, you just copy the 4. Look, we have like terms here. Okay. Y squared times y squared is y to the 4. Positive times negative, or simply it's negative, minus. Okay, 2, don't forget. So we just write the 2. Y squared, copy. Y squared. And copy the 3. We have 3 here, and last is negative 3, times negative 3 is always positive, 3 times 3 is 9. 1 to the 4th, minus, it's minus, 2 times 3, two numbers only, we have 6, copy the y squared there, y squared, rest, right, and then add 9. So we have x times x, x squared, and then minus, minus, 2 times 5 is 10, times x is 10x, and then negative 5 times negative 5 is positive 25. So number 6, we have 5x minus 2, nothing, plus x minus 2 squared, oh, this one is the square of binomials. So you can try this one again. 5x minus 2. Cannot multiply this one because there is minus. Right. 5x minus 2. Plus here. Then and plus here. Now we will put this one inside the parentheses. But it's okay. You can open the parentheses or remove the parentheses without changing its sign because this one is positive. So let's have this one, the shortcut. X times x, x squared minus minus 2 times 2, 4 times x, 4x. So you have 4x there. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4 plus 4. Okay, okay, we copy again and here. 5x minus 2. When we open this one, because this one is positive, we just copy the signs. They are the same. So plus x squared here minus 4x and the plus 4 equals. Then we just add. So let's have that x squared first because this one is positive. And x squared here, and then we need to combine this. like terms. So you have 5x minus 4x, or 5x negative 4x is 1x. Positive, so we just write it 1x. That's 1x plus x. 5x minus 4x. What about the numbers? Negative 2 and positive 4, we subtract. So you have positive 2. And that is our answer for number 6. Right, number 7. Oh, what is this one? Could you still remember this one? Sum and difference of binomials. You have 2x, 2x, 3, 3, 1 is plus, 1 is minus. So 2x times 2x, 2 times 2 is 4. X times x is x squared. It's always negative here. 3 times 3 is 9 here. Minus, okay. We enclose the answer, the product of this x plus 1 squared inside the parentheses. Okay. X times x, we have x squared. The sum is plus, so we have plus 2 times 1 is 2 times x is 2x. So we have 2x here. And 1 times 1 is 1. Plus 1. Okay. Now we will open or remove the parentheses here, but this one is negative. So what will happen to the signs here? It will change. This one will change to negative, to negative, and to negative. So let's say this one. You copy 4x squared minus 9, and then this positive will change to negative. X squared, this one will change to negative. Minus 2x, this one will change to negative. So negative 1, and then we combine like terms. We combine 4x squared minus x squared. So 4x squared minus 1x squared is 3x squared. Minus 2x, there's only 1 negative 2x. So copy minus 2x. And the numbers, negative 9 and negative 1 gives us negative 10. So that is our answer for number 7. We have two square root binomials. Negative and the positive there. But this one's plus, it's okay. So here, square it. 1 times 1 is 1. Minus, minus. 2 times 1, 2 times x, 2x. Let's turn negative times negative is positive here. X times x is x squared plus. So x times x squared plus. So it's plus 2 times 2, 4 times x, 4x here. Let's turn this over is plus 2 times 2 is 4. Now let's have this one, the x squared. Here we add this x squared and x squared. 1 x squared plus 1 x squared is 2 x squared. And then followed by the x. Okay, this is minus 2 x and 4 x. We have plus 2 x here. And then last is the 4. It's positive, and the one is also positive, so we add plus 5 here, and that is number 8. Let's have the derivation of the area of this square and the rectangles, and you will show that this square a plus b is equal to a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Okay, so we have the square here, the overall square. It's a square, means they have the same length of the sides. Okay. We have a square here, a small square. This is a square. Sine A here, and A there. Square of side A. The second square is this one. A small square, which has a side of B. This one is B. Therefore, this one is B also, because this one is a square. B and B. And we have two rectangles. One is this, and the second one is this. Two rectangles, two squares, and we have the overall square. So what is now the length of this one? So it will be A plus B. So we are going to put here the length of this one is A plus B. This one's from here to there. What about the other one? If this one is a square, therefore this one is also A plus B, from here up to here. Can you check that one? Yes. This one is A up to here, and from here is B. So A plus B total. So that's the checking. Now, number one, we get the area of the overall or the largest square. Here, A plus B times A plus B. That is the overall area of our square. So if we are going to write that one, we have this side is A plus B, and that side there is also A plus B, in which we can write this one as 1 and 1 as A plus B to the second power, this one. That's the overall area. Now, so let's have the area of square 1. What is the area of square 1? Here. So that one is A times A. So here we have A times A is equal to A squared. That is the area of this one. Alright, area of rectangle 2. That rectangle there, what's the area of that one? So that one is B times this one. What is this one? It's A. You cannot find it there. It's A. Here. So we are here. Why not we first we write A? A times B. So we have AB or BA. AB. Now, area of rectangle 3, this one. What is this one? It's A. So this one is A. And what is this one? It's B. So what's the area of rectangle 3? It's A times B. So we have AB. So we have the same, AB. And then the last one, the area of the square, number 4. What is this one? It's B. And what is this one? It's B. So B times B is B squared. We are going to add this 1, 2, 3, 4. The four areas must be equal to the A plus B squared. So let us add, we have the A squared. So we have A squared. AB plus AB was 2AB. So plus 2AB. That's why we have always the 2 there. And then plus the B squared. And that's how to prove that this A plus B of the square of binomial is equal to A squared plus 2AB plus B squared. Okay. Thank you, learners.